Welcome to Insight from NTI. Today we'll be looking at NTI's ENVIROMUX Medium Enterprise Environment Monitoring System. This device monitors many connected sensors in real time and sends out alerts when a sensor exceeds a configurable threshold. The E5D features an internal temperature and humidity sensor. It has dual DC power for dual redundancy and is available with optional backup battery or 48 VDC power. The power switch manually turns the unit on or off. The cable restraint is used to secure the power connection to the ENVIROMUX system. This RJ45 jack provides 10 100 base T Ethernet connection for remote configuration and monitoring. The USB Type-B connector is used for connecting a PC for serial terminal access. The four LEDs, two here and two on the other side, indicate power and fault. The RJ45 RS232 auxiliary port is used for connecting a serial GSM modem or a remote serially controlled device. Two alarm buttons, one here and one on the other side, are used to test or silence a connected siren. The system reset button manually reboots the E5D, while the restore defaults button restores the system to factory settings. The four USB ports are used for connecting a USB modem or for downloading log data to USB flash drives. The five digital inputs are used for connecting dry contact devices. This terminal block powers an auxiliary device with 12 VDC power. The two normally open or closed digital outputs are used to control external devices in the event of alerts. The terminal block labeled alarm is used for connecting visual and audible alarm indicators. The RJ45 sensor ports are used for connecting up to five external sensors, such as temperature, humidity, liquid detection, smoke, vibration, motion, and power monitoring. The web interface allows you to configure and monitor the E5D unit and all connected sensors. The monitoring section allows you to configure and view the status of all connected sensors, IP cameras, and more. The summary page displays the description, type, value, and status for all connected sensors and devices. Users can view the sensor settings by clicking on the sensor's name. To update the sensor configuration, select Edit from the summary page or Configure from the sensor page. Select the alarm summary page to view only the sensors and alarm status. To handle an alert, go to the sensor page and select Dismiss or Acknowledge. The digital inputs, IP devices, IP sensors, output relays, and power supplies pages allow you to view the summaries for those specific groups. On the IP cameras tab, you can view a live feed of all connected sensors. The administration section allows you to configure the system settings, enterprise and GSM settings, network settings, add one admin and up to 15 users, create up to 8 user groups, configure security settings, view system information, update the firmware, configure cascade settings, and reboot the system. In the Smart Alerts section, sensor conditions can be configured as events to trigger alerts and/or be used in combination with multiple events and sensors to trigger smart alerts. Up to 50 events and 20 smart alerts can be configured. A new event can be added by clicking Create New Event. Sensor configurations for these events will have no impact on the general configuration of your sensors. User-defined events provide more control over what you want to be notified of. Any configured event or sensor can be applied to the OR lists and/or the AND lists. The logical function combines the two values to determine if a smart alert should be sent. The log section allows users to view and configure event and data logs. The event log lists when events occur within the system, such as system startup, user login, logout, sensor alerts, and when an alert is acknowledged or dismissed by a user. The data log lists all sensor and IP address readings. The support section provides direct links to the user manual and downloads page that contains firmware files and release notes. For a free 30-day evaluation, call 1-330-562-7070 or email us at sales@ntigo.com.